using those fists. Can't blame him after the tactics of the assassin and Dory Funk Jr. And Lawler, solid left-hand lead, now comes out of the backyard with a right-hand haymaker that puts the assassin down.
The assassin, I think he goes around 275, 280. And Lawler looks like he's just about the same size as the assassin. And boy, when he brings him out of right field there and lands him on home plate, hey, Bucky, you got to be a superman to ever come back again and see the rest of that match.
Well, he connected that time right on the button with the assassin, drove him down. The assassin coming around, and now it's Dory Funk Jr. in the ring. And Funk, a master in the ring, there's no question about it, an absolute master. He is in total control of his mind and body at all times. I don't believe I have ever seen Dory Funk Jr. totally lose his cool. I've seen flashes occasionally of anger, but I've never seen him lose his cool to a point where he makes a serious mistake.
Well, years ago I used to call him Young Clock, but with the age of computers, I'd say he's the computer of the wrestling world. He's the top computer machine of the wrestling world. And you're right, Gordon. He does keep his cool. Ooh. Bad move right there.
Well, that's the other thing about Funk. He will take advantage of situations, will drive an advantage when it suits him. He's a great one for the element of surprise. Now you see here, in my opinion, making a mistake. He was arguing with the referee. Funk and the assassin very quickly took advantage of that situation to dish up more punishment to Jerry Lawler. Lawler, on that canvas, in a lot of trouble now. And Funk closes in on him again.
Well, there's no doubt about it. When you have a former world champion and a great one, he was a great one for 4 years, in your corner, And when you're the other man in the corner, and you're the number one or two contenders for that world title, you're up in the top five anyhow, and you're a brute of a man, that's a rough, tough combination. Just to beat, that's all. It's true they're going up against two great athletes in Lawler and Cook. But boy, that's a tough combination to go against. Whoever thought of joining up Dory Funk Jr. and the assassin in a tag team, it was a diabolical mind.
Well, one thing for sure, it took the very, very best of two particular types of wrestler, put them together, and Funk now, with those devastating forearms, has Lawler up against those turnbuckles and in a lot of trouble. And you talk about getting your brain scrambled, Lawler trying to shake his head and clear it, and Lawler and Funk maybe going one step too far. Lawler being jolted time after time after time with those forearms, comes back with a clubbing right hand, makes the tag. Charlie Cook moves in, and Charlie Cook, not spending any time on the amenities of the day, moves in with a beautiful high knee lift that has Funk step back to the canvas. Cook caught him, a good shoulder smash coming off the rope. Cook charges him again, uses that shoulder effectively. It was Charlie Cook over that top rope as he caught the assassin, and the referee spotted it. The referee caught it. Excellent officiating on the part of the referee. He saw the assassin give Charlie Cook a boost over that rope. He immediately called for the bell, an automatic disqualification. We've got a battle going on outside the ring now. The bell has rung, but Cook being brought back in, and it is Dory Funk Jr. administering more punishment. It is Lawler outside as the assassin and Dory Funk Jr. now punishing Charlie Cook. 2-on-1, the bell has already rung. The match is over, but the assassin and Dory Funk Jr. Administering punishment far above and beyond the situation here. And, well, again, they're futilely ringing that bell. The referee trying to get order restored. Charlie Cook and Jerry Lawler, the victors in this, and wait a second. Lawler starts moving back in, and it is working on Dory Funk Jr. now. Letting some right hands fly, and Charlie Cook is back on his feet. And the assassin through the rope, and he and Dory Funk Jr., I'm sure, are thinking that there'll be another day. But the victors in this match, be it his qualification, Charlie Cook and Jerry Lawler.